When building anything, it's always a good idea to start with a firm foundation and solid supporting structure. The HTML elements in our index.html file have no supporting structure. And for little demo apps, that may be fine. But when creating full-featured web pages, we want to ensure we build our documents on solid footings. This recommended supporting structure for every web page includes these elements and attributes. The doctype tells the browser that this document is an HTML document. This tag is not an HTML element. It begins with a bang or exclamation point, then doctype in uppercase, a space, and HTML. The HTML element is the root element of the page. All of the other elements should be nested inside this HTML element. We can see the closing tag at the bottom of the document. Set the lang attribute to the primary language of the page, which in this case is EN for English. Setting the language helps search engines and screen readers interpret the page content. Everything nested within the HTML element is divided into head and body. Elements under the head element provide additional information to the browser that is not displayed on the web page. And the body element contains the markup content that the browser reads and displays. The content we've created so far would go within this body element. The primary purpose of the head element is to provide information to the browser about how the document should be displayed, but none of its content is displayed on the web page. At a minimum, the head element should contain these elements. The meta element is for metadata. Metadata is basically data about data. In this context, it provides information, or data, to the browser about how the document's data should be displayed. The first meta element defines the character set to use for the document. We set the character set attribute to UTF-8 because that character set includes most characters from most languages, so the page will be able to display any language. This tag should always be immediately after the head tag. The second meta element is primarily used for compatibility with older versions of Microsoft's Internet Explorer or IE browser. Use the IE=edge to specify the highest mode. If you have to support older versions of IE with your website, consult the documentation on which compatibility setting to use. The last meta element shown here controls the browser's viewport, which is the part of the browser window that contains the web page. These are typically values for a mobile-optimized site, since these settings are ignored on a desktop. Width equal device width sets the viewport width to the width of the screen. This initial scale sets the zoom level when the page is first loaded. Like this last example, many other meta elements have name and content attributes. The name defines the type of metadata element, and the content provides the content for that type. There is an author meta element, for example. We could use that to add the page author. See the MDN documentation for the list of standard meta name attribute values. You can find a link in the lesson links at the end of this lesson. Other common elements within the head element include the title, which we'll talk about in a moment, and link elements that define the style sheets for the web page. We'll talk more about styles in the CSS course later in this series. Going back to the title element, it can only contain text, not other elements. It sets the title that appears in the browser tab. It's used as the bookmark text if the user defines a bookmark to the page, and it's the text that appears in search results. This is especially important when building public-facing websites instead of sites for use within a company. And it's used by screen readers to help identify the page to the user. Here are some tips for creating a great title. Be descriptive. A longer descriptive title will be prioritized higher in search results than a short, more generic title. Be interesting. An interesting title has a higher chance of drawing the user's attention in the search results. Be unique. Come up with a unique and descriptive title for each page of your site. Be consistent. Use a form such as unique page name, colon, site name. And some don'ts. Don't be too long. Search engines display about 50 to 60 characters of the title, so don't make it longer than that. Don't be word salad, meaning don't make your title just a bunch of keywords. Many search algorithms will reduce the priority of pages without meaningful titles. Let's add this recommended supporting structure to our HTML document. Open the index.html file in your text editor. I'll press Enter a few times to give us some space. Here at the top, we type the doctype. Don't forget the bang at the front and type it uppercase. Specify the document type as HTML. Then we add the opening tag for the HTML element and set the lang attribute to en for English. We add its closing tag at the very bottom of the file. Everything else should be between this opening and closing tag. Next, we add the head element opening and closing tags. Here we'll put anything we don't want to display on the page. Let's leave a blank line for readability. Then we add the opening tag for the body element above our content, and the body closing tag after our content and before the HTML closing tag. Going back up, inside the head tags, we define the meta tags. I'll paste them in. If you don't want to type all of the text, scroll down below this video to the lesson links at the bottom of this lesson. There you can link to the code for this coding along exercise and copy the text from there. Feel free to add other meta elements, such as the page author. Lastly, let's set the page title. Since this is the main page of our site, we'll set the title to the site name, Virtual Pet Cafe. Feel free to indent the elements inside the body element for readability and for help matching up closing and opening tags. Save the document. Now let's open the index.html file in the browser and ensure the page still appears as it did. Looks the same, but notice that the browser tab now displays our page title. If all is well, we can close the text editor. But what if the page doesn't display or doesn't look right? What then? Let's go back to the slides. Here are some tips for resolving issues with your HTML. Keep these tips handy as you work through the remainder of this course. Check each element. Ensure tags have both left and right angle brackets. Ensure every element that should have a closing tag has a closing tag. Check that each element is spelled correctly in both the opening and closing tag. Be sure element names are lowercase. Check each attribute. Ensure the attribute is spelled correctly, is lowercase, and if it has a value, the value is enclosed in opening and closing quotes. Check an element's nesting. A nested element should have both its opening and closing tag nested within, basically inside, the container element, like this. Not like this. Here the opening p tag is inside the body element, but its closing tag isn't. Indenting can help you confirm your nesting. Be sure you save your latest changes and that you've refreshed your browser to reload those changes. And note that the browser will do its best to display something, even if you make mistakes. So, an HTML page has a recommended supporting structure, as shown here. Add elements to the head section to provide information the browser should know, but not display. Information like the character set, browser compatibility, viewport, and title. Links to style sheets will also go here. The body section contains the marked up content. The browser will read and display this content on the web page. Now that you know the very basics of building an HTML document, in the next lesson, let's look at some web developer tools. Then we'll examine more HTML elements.